Hey guys, and welcome to this channel. In this channel, we are going to take a look at some photo books in order to attain inspiration and get familiar with some good photographers and obviously their methods and techniques, and maybe get the answer to this question that why we love photography. Okay, the photographer that we are going to look at his work today is called Hans Ekelboom. Ekelboom is a Dutch photographer born in 1949 and studied fine art at Boomgeving in Den Bosch. And then he continued his study at Academy of Fine Arts in Arnhem. He's a street photographer who was always focused on fashions and clothes of the people in the street, and he's doing this work for around 25 years. But this dedication to his work led him toward the point that Martin Parr, the great documentary photographer, said this sentence about him: "If I were an anthropologist, the first photographer I would call upon is Hans Ekelboom. In fact, if I were a visitor from another planet looking for information on the nature of city life, I would also engage the services of Ekelboom." Martin Parr. As you may know, Martin Parr has also has some anthropological approaches in his work, and this shows that this photographer also does the same. And anthropology is simply the scientific study of humans and human behavior and, of course, societies. So let's dig in. The name of the book, as you can see, is Paris, New York and Shanghai. It starts with part 1, Paris. Okay, by seeing these photos, the first thing that we see is that these are not meant to be seen individually. Because if you see them as some individual photographs, you may not be impressed because they aren't some good photos in terms of lighting or composition or posing or whatever that you expect from a good portrait shot. But in fact, you have to look at them together. And as you can see here, all the photos are focused on men on the street that wear a striped t-shirt in this case. As we go through the book, we can see that the photographer mixed the pictures of people on the street with some photos of cityscape, and of course that this one is taken all in Paris from different types of people that you can see and find on the street. And the thing that I really liked here, that he photographed people with the army pattern clothing, but he mixed it with some buildings that has the same camouflage pattern on them. These are all taxi drivers, some cityscapes, old ladies dressed up, people eating in cafes, people with luggages. Couples, more cityscape, and remember these perspectives because there is a point to it that I'm going to mention later. People that bought something from a shop, from a specific shop. Playgrounds, bikers, police officers, more city escapes, mostly from green places and parks. And as you continue, you can see all sorts of people. He definitely tried not to miss a type. Suited ladies, and it's over. But the interesting thing about this book is that this was part one, and there is more, because it has glued to another book that begins the part two, New York. And again, we can see that it starts with pictures of men in a striped t-shirts and clothes, again some cityscapes, again girls in tops, again cityscapes, suited men. And do you remember the picture of the couples that came before the cityscapes that I mentioned and talked about the perspective? I'm going to say something about that too. Okay, this is the couples, and the pictures next to it has the same perspective and the viewing angle of the ones in the Paris. So it was important for Ekelbun to sustain a similar picture in both cities, and this needs some serious dedication to the work. Again, policemen, parts, ladies. And again, when you reach at the end, it becomes another book, and it's attached to part 3, which is named Shanghai. And he did the same in Shanghai, photographed some people with some specific similar features and mixed them up with some cityscapes. And again, it was so important for him to make the pictures look similar so that we can compare them and watch the differences and of course similarities at the same time. And this is what makes him and his work and this book in a specific special. So as you can see, he photographed three big cities in the world, and seeing these photos make you realize how small the world can be, because they are living in different places, both in terms of geography and culture, but they are still very similar to each other. Anyways guys, hope you enjoyed and liked this video. There's gonna be more of these, so hang around and see you later. Peace.